Good morning, class. Today we will further discuss about the packing fraction of FCC arrangement and BCC arrangement. So, in case of simple cubic system, we saw the packing fraction in case of simple cubic arrangement, the packing fraction was 0.524. The packing fraction was 0.524. Now, if the packing fraction is 0.24, then the percentage of occupied space, percentage of occupied space is equal to 0.52 multiplied by 100. This will be equal to 52.4%. This will be equal to 52.4%, and the percentage of unoccupied space and the percentage of unoccupied space is equal to 100 minus 52.4%. That will be equal to 47.6%. That means, or this unoccupied space is also known as voids. The space which are vacant or unoccupied, these are known as voids. So, in case of simple cubic system or primitive unit cell, the packing fraction we calculated was 0.524. And if the packing fraction is 0.524, that means the percentage of occupied space would be equal to 0.524 multiplied by 100. That will be equal to 52.4%. And if the 52.4% is the packing fraction or it is the occupied space, that means the percentage of unoccupied space or void would be 100 minus 52.4%. This will come out to be 47.6%. So, this is the occupied space and this is the unoccupied space, which is also known as voids, or they are also known as interstices. Now, this was all about simple cubic system or primitive unit cell. Now, we are going to discuss about BCC arrangement or body centered unit cell. Now, next would be second one, that is body centered unit cell, or it is also known as BCC arrangement. Body centered unit cell, or this is also known as BCC arrangement. Now, let us see what is this BCC arrangement. Let this be a unit cell. Let this be a unit cell, and let it be a body centered unit cell. That means we have a particle at the body center. We have a particle at the body center, not particularly here. Let it be here. And the particles we will take two opposite particles which are situated at the two corners. So, these are the particles situated on the corners, and this red one represents the particle which is present at the body center. So, these are the particles which are situated at the corners, and this is the sphere or the particle which is situated at the body center. Now, again we will consider, let the edge length be A, let the edge length be A, and let the radius of particle be small r. Radius of particle be equal to small r. Now, let this be point A, this be point B, this be point C, and this be point D. So, first of all, this distance is A, that is edge length. This distance is A, and this distance is also A because of edge length. So, first of all, we will calculate the body diagonal AB, and then we will calculate the body diagonal AD. First of all, we will calculate the face diagonal AB, and then we will calculate the body diagonal AD. Now, let us prove this one side. In triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, we have to calculate the value of AB, and this will be equal to, according to Pythagoras theorem, this will be equal to AC square plus BC square. Sorry, this will be equal to, let this point be C. So, AC square plus BC square, both the points are A, that means A square plus A square, and now AB will be equal to root 2 A. This is equation number 1, AB will be equal to root 2 A. This is equation number 1. After that, in triangle, and this AB is nothing but face diagonal. This is face diagonal. This AB is face diagonal. Now, in triangle ABD, in triangle ABD, the body diagonal AD is equal to, body diagonal AD is equal to root BD AB square plus BD square, or this will be equal to root of, AB was calculated out to be root 2A and AB is A square, or this will be equal to square of, this will be equal to square of root 2A. So, this will be equal to 2A square plus A square, or it will be equal to root 3A. So, the value of AD comes out to be root 3A, this is equation number 2. And from this expression, this value is R from here to here, this value is R and this value is also R, all the three values are R. These three values are R, this is also R, this is also R, this is also R. So, according to the diagram, AD is equal to 4R, equation number 3. According to equation 2nd and 3rd, we can write root 3A is equal to 4R, or A is equal to 4 by root 3R. This is equation number 4. This is equation number 4. The edge length A, where A is the edge length, the edge and length A has the value of 4 upon root 3 R. Now, we have to calculate the packing fraction PF, and the packing fraction is equal to volume of particles upon volume of unit cell. So, in case of BCC arrangement, we have two particles and the volume of one particle is 4 by 3 pi r cube, and volume of unit cell would be A cube. The value of A we have derived over there. So, we can apply here, it will be equal to 8 pi 3 pi r cube, and the value of A is 4 by root 3 r cube. So, r cube would be cancelled, this, and it will be cube of this. So, the value would be equal to 8 by 3 pi upon 65 upon 3 root 3, or this will be equal to 8 by 3 multiplied by 3 root 3 upon 64 pi. On solving, we will have the value of 0.68. This is the value. or we can write over there, the packing fraction for a BCC arrangement is 0.868. The packing fraction for a BCC arrangement is 0.68. Now, in case of BCC arrangement, the percentage of occupied space, is equal to 0.68 multiplied by 100, that will be equal to 68%, and the percentage of unoccupied space or this is also known as void, it will be equal to 100 minus 68%, and this will be equal to 32%. So, in case of BCC arrangement, the occupied space percentage would be equal to 68%, and case of BCC arrangement, we have unoccupied space or void to be 32%. This is the arrangement. Now, the next would be third one, for face centered unit cell, for face centered unit cell or FCC arrangement. So, let us assume this one case. Let this be a face, we have isolated a face, since a cube, since a unit cell is cubical in shape. So, we are discussing about face centered unit cell, we have isolated or we have cut out a single face of the cube or that of unit cell. So, let this be a face or a part of the unit cell, and let this be the particle situated at the face center. And let be this be the particle situated at one corner, and this be the particle situated at the other corner. This is point A, this is point B, and this is point C. And this is face diagonal AB. This is R, and this is also R. This is A, edge length A, and this is also A, edge length. So, again we will assume the both the terms. Let the edge length be A, and let the radius of particle be small r. Let the two terms be there. Now, in triangle ABC, face diagonal AB is equal to root of AC square plus BC square. This will be equal to root of A square plus A square, and this will be equal to root 2A. Equation number 1, AB is equal to root 2A, equation number 1. Now, AB is equal to, from that figure, AB is equal to, this is R, this is 2R, and this is because it is the diameter. This is R, this is 2R, and this is R. So, from the figure, AB will be equal to 4R, equation number 2. From equation 1 and equation 2, we can have root 2A is equal to 4R, or A is equal to 4 R by root 2, this will be the value of A. Equation number 3, equation number 3, or this will be equal to A is equal to 2 root 2 R. Equation number 4, A will be equal to 2 root 2 R. Now, we have to calculate the packing fraction, that will be equal to volume of particles, upon volume of unit cell, Now, this will be equal to volume of particle would be, in case of face centered unit cell we have 4 particles. So, it will be equal to 4 multiplied by 4 by 3 pi r cube upon volume of unit cell would be equal to a cube, or this will be equal to 16 upon 3 pi r cube upon, the value of a cube is 2 root 2 r whole cube, or this will be equal to 16 by 3 pi r cube upon, this will be equal to 8 or 16, or rather we should say the complete equation will be equal to 0.74. Now, the percentage of occupied space, would be equal to 0.74 multiplied by 100, and this will be equal to 74%. 0.74 multiplied by 100, this will be equal to 74%, and the percentage of unoccupied space, or better it is known as void, is equal to 100 minus 74%, and this is equal to 26%. So, in case of face centered unit cell, the percentage of occupied space is 74% and the percentage of unoccupied is 26%, or it is also better known as void or interstices. So, this was all about calculation of packing fraction. For first we saw in case of simple or primitive unit cell, then we saw about body centered unit cell, and at last we saw about face centered unit cell, or better it is known as FCC arrangement. Now, this was all about the cases of different things. Next, we have to discuss about the things like, let us see the case of voids, or they are also known as interstices, or they are also known as voids or interstices, or they are also known as unoccupied spaces, these are the different units to be used for the same. Now, the voids or interstices, the wherever there is an arrangement of particle in any system or in a cubic arrangement, we have some left spaces or unoccupied spaces, because the particles are not present everywhere. So, the spaces which are left unoccupied, or the spaces where particles are not found, those spaces are called voids, or they are also known as interstices. So, in case of voids, when we are discussing about voids, so voids are of particularly three types. First are trigonal voids, or they are also known as triangular voids. The next is tetrahedral void, and the third one is octahedral void. If a void is found by three particles, by the arrangement of three particles, then it is called trigonal or triangular void. If a void is found by four particles, it is formed by four particles, by the arrangement of four particles, then it is called tetrahedral void. And if a void is formed by the arrangement of six particles around itself, then it is called octahedral void. So, it depends upon the arrangement of particles around a given system or a given unoccupied space. If it is formed by three particles, it is called triangular or trigonal void. If it is formed by four particles, it is called tetrahedral void. And it is formed by octahedral, if it is formed by six particles, it is called octahedral void. Now, if it is triangular void, it can be of two types. It can be either trigonal void A, and the second one would be, it can be either trigonal void B. In case of trigonal void A, we have the arrangement like this: two particles above and one particle below. This space in between is known as void A or trigonal void A. And the arrangement is like this: one particle above and two particles below. So, the empty space which is formed in between these three particles, it is called void B. So, this is void A and this is void B. This particular position is void A and this particular empty space is void B. Thank you, class.